In this video, we will discuss a real-life example, that is hyperparameter optimization for deep learning using particle swarm optimization. So here we will create a hybrid approach by combining deep learning with a meta-heuristic algorithm, that is PSO. So we will build and train a CNN for image classification to identify different types of LAR from images. So our goal is to find the best hyperparameters to maximize the model's accuracy. The objective is clear here. We want to build a CNN to classify images of LAR into different categories. We will optimize the hyperparameters of the CNN to improve classification accuracy. So as we are creating here the hybrid approach by combining the deep learning with PSO algorithm. So first we will discuss basic about deep learning. After that, we will discuss this real life example. About artificial intelligence, we all know it is a branch of computer science, and using artificial intelligence, we are trying to create machines or software that are capable of performing tasks that require human intelligence. A task like pattern recognition, problem solving, decision making, language understanding. So deep learning, you can see here, it is a subset of machine learning in artificial intelligence that mimics the working of human brain in data processing, creating patterns for use in decision making. So this process involves the use of neural networks with many deep layers. So we have here artificial neural network with many deep layers that can learn and make intelligent decisions on their own. We are trying to create machines or software as intelligent as human brain so that they can make intelligent decisions on their own. So we have different key concepts in deep learning. For example, first you can see here we have artificial neural network. ANN, that is the core component in deep learning inspired by the working of human brain. This consists of neurons, that is nodes here, and these nodes are connected by the edges. So you can see here artificial neural network are structured in the layers. We have three important layers in ANN: input layer, hidden layer, and the output layer. Input layer receives the input data. Hidden layer, that is the intermediate layer that process the input received from the input layer. After that, we have third layer, that is the output layer, that provide us the final output. Now let's try to understand the working of artificial neural network using this simple example having three layers: input layer, hidden layer, and output layer. We will predict house prices based on features. We have two features: size of the house and the number of bedrooms. So first we have the scenario. So suppose we have a data set with two. So we will consider that we have a data set with these two features: size of the houses, that is in the square feet. Second feature, we have the number of bedrooms, and the target variable is here we need the price of the house. So price of the house is the target variable. We have three layers in ANN: input layer, hidden layer, and the output layer. So for this example, for the input layer, this layer has two neurons, one for each feature. We have size of the house and the number of bedrooms. Second, we have the hidden layer. Suppose we have one hidden layer with three neurons. After that, in the output layer, this layer has one neuron, that is the target variable that predicting the house price. Then in the input layer, we have two neurons, that is one for each feature. We have one hidden layer with three neurons. In the output layer, we have one neuron that is predicting the house price as the output. So first you can see the connection from input to hidden layer. So we have forward propagation. So the input layer neuron received the features value, and each hidden neuron will calculate a weighted sum of inputs, add a bias, and apply an activation function. So to introduce the non-linearity, activation functions are applied to each neuron. And the commonly used activation function we have here: rectified linear unit, or you can use your sigmoid. So we have two input features here, that is the size and the number of bedrooms. Suppose x1 and x2, x1 for the size, x2 for the number of bedrooms. Now the weights from the input layer to the hidden layer are denoted with W, and the bias we have small b. Now we will calculate the output of the hidden layer neuron by adding weight by using this. We have weights from the input layer, then feature plus bias. After that, we will apply here the activation function that we are using here, rectified linear unit, output of the hidden layer neuron that we calculated here. After that, we have hidden to output layer. You can see this connection. So now we will pass the hidden layer output to the output layer. Now the output layer neuron will calculate a weighted sum of the hidden layer outputs, add a bias, and apply a linear activation function, as we are predicting the continuous values. So we will calculate the output using this. After that, we have the back propagation. We will compute the loss. We'll use here a loss function to measure the difference between predicted and the actual prices. So we can use here mean square error for the regression task. So we use this simple example to just show the how data is processed between these three layers. We have further more steps. So we did here just the forward propagation. After that, we will do the back propagation. In back propagation, we will compute the loss, calculate the gradients, update weights. After that, we will start the training. So we have multiple applications of deep learning. We can use deep learning in image processing, in natural language processing, speech recognition. For example, in image processing, deep learning model like CNN are widely used for image and the video processing. Here we can do facial recognition, object detection, medical images analysis, and many. In natural language processing, deep learning is used for the task like language translation, chatbots, sentiment analysis. In speech recognition, deep learning is used in voice activation assistants. You can see an assistant like Siri, Alexa. Deep learning help them in converting speech to text and understanding the spoken language. You can also use deep learning in self-driving cars for recommendation system, like in Amazon to recommend the products, in Netflix to recommend the movies. Like that, we have a multiple application of deep learning. Now we will try to understand how we can use deep learning. So first we have to define the problem clearly. So first we will state the problem that we want to solve, and then we will check if deep learning is suitable for this problem or not. And if deep learning is suitable for this problem, after that we will gather the data. We'll gather the data and prepare the data that will be used for the training models. So next step is data collection. Once it is done that we can solve this problem using deep learning, we will start data collection. After that, we will choose the model. So after that, we will train this model. We will use the collected data for training the model. So now we will focus on the example, that is the hyperparameter optimization for deep learning using particle swarm optimization. So our aim is to train a CNN for image classification. We will identify different types of flower from images. The goal is here to find the hyperparameters to maximize the model accuracy. So we can use deep learning to solve any problem. First, we have to define the problem, where we will clearly state the problem that we want to solve, and we will check if deep learning is suitable for this or not. After that, start data collection, pre-processing that we will use for the model training. After that, we will choose the model. Here we have to select an appropriate neural network architecture. For example, we can use CNN for images, RNN for the sequential data. So problem is clear, what we want to do. Data is collected, model is also selected. Now we will start the training. Now we will train the model. Here we will use a training data set to train the model. We will adjust the weights through back propagation to minimize the loss. After training, we will validate the model. Here we will evaluate the model's performance using validation data set. For example, you're training a model for the face recognition and you trained it on a specific data set and your model is now working properly. Now suppose new images are given to you. Now you have to do the face recognition for the new images. During model testing, we can access the model performance on the new data, whether it is giving the accurate results on the new data or not. After that, we will deploy the model. Here we will integrate the trained model into your application or the system where it can make predictions or the decision in real time. Done. Lastly, we have the monitor and the maintenance. We'll continuously monitor the model performance and retrain it with new data when needed to maintain its accuracy and reliability. We have certain tools that we can use, like TensorFlow, that is an open framework developed by Google for machine learning and deep learning tasks. PyTorch, that is also an open source machine learning library developed by Facebook AI Research Lab. Like that, we have a number of tools that we can use for these tasks. Now we'll try to understand this with a real life example. By combining meta-heuristic algorithm with deep learning, we can create a powerful hybrid approaches for solving complex real life problems. As we know, meta-heuristic algorithm, they can find near optimal solution for the difficult problems. And here we use the iterative process for more improvement. Now we have this example. We will optimize the hyperparameters in deep learning using PSO. First, we will define the problem. That is the problem definition. Suppose we are using the model here, CNN. We want to identify different types of flour from the images. So here we will choose the model that is CNN. Train a model that is CNN for the image classification so that we can identify different types of flour from images. Our goal is clear here. We want to find the best hyperparameters to maximize the model's accuracy. Now we will start the process. So we have a hybrid approach here, deep learning and meta-heuristic algorithm PSO. So we are using here deep learning model that we will combine with meta-heuristic algorithm PSO. So deep learning model, we will build a CNN to classify images of flour into different categories. So we'll use CNN with different layers. After using PSO, our objective is to optimize the hyperparameters of the CNN to improve the classification accuracy. So we have a simple process in meta-heuristic algorithm. First, we initialize the population. So here we'll create a swarm of particles. Each particle represents a potential solution, that is a set of hyperparameters. After that, we have position update, velocity update. Each particle can adjust its position based on its own experience and the experience of the neighboring particles. The social behavior is simulated here using different mathematical models. We can update the agent's position in the search space by considering the personal best and the global best values. After that, we'll start the evaluation. We'll train the CNN with the hyperparameters represented by the each particle, and we will evaluate its performance. After that, we'll continuously update the velocity position of each particle until convergence or a specific number of iteration. When it is reached, we will stop and display the output. Now here, hyperparameters, we have like learning rate, batch size, number of convolution layer, number of filters. Done. Define the hyperparameters to be optimized. After that, we'll initialize the swarm with random position and the velocities. Here we have each agent or particle in the swarm represent the set of hyperparameters. After that, we'll integrate PSO with deep learning. It means we will integrate PSO with the model training. So for each particle, we will train the CNN using hyperparameters to represent and evaluate its performance. After that, update the particle's velocities and then update their position by adding the updated velocity into their previous position on the evaluation results. We will repeat the process until optimal set of hyperparameters is found or until the stopping control criteria is met. So deep learning component that we are using here, CNN. So when we will integrate PSO with CNN, for each particle set CNN hyperparameters according to the particle's position. Train the CNN, after that train the CNN and evaluate its performance. Update the particle's velocity position based on their evaluation results. Iterate until the best hyperparameters are found. After that, train the final model. We will train the CNN with the optimized. After that, finally, we will train the CNN with the optimized hyperparameters on the entire training dataset. And we will evaluate the number of performance on test dataset. We'll start the testing to evaluate the final model on a test dataset to validate its performance. So benefit of using hybrid approach, we can optimize the hyperparameters using PSO that can significantly improve the model accuracy and it can reduce time. So if you're working on any project, you can create a hybrid approach that is best, because when we create a hybrid approach, we will combine the strength of both techniques. For example, we are combining here the strength of deep learning with the strength of PSO algorithm to solve a problem. So like that, we can solve a number of real world problems. Just follow the simple steps and create the model. So that's all about this video. If you have any questions, you can comment below. And thanks for watching this video.